Now we are going to discuss the fourth part of comparing six theories. In this part, we will be discussing the classroom application of these theories. Pearneman states, it is important to know what is learnable at what point in time. Learning is not random. Teachers or learners or students or all the stakeholders need to be aware of the learning objectives and the appropriate time for learning a particular object or particular aspect of language. Theory's application in classroom aims to address the issues of learners' needs and appropriate learning procedures to cater to their needs. So the need analysis is very important because it's the learner who is the learners who are the focal point or the center of learning. Therefore, their needs or analysis of their needs is crucial. And then the appropriate learning procedure to cater to those needs are a huge challenge and a huge task for the language teachers. SLA research does offer a wide variety of concepts and data that can enable teachers to reflect on their own classroom experiences as well as provide ideas for classroom use. So based on their own particular experiences in following a particular approach in a classroom, teachers can reflect and modify and prepare teaching methodologies or introduce and evolve teaching practices. Looking at the classroom applications of all these theories, we see that behaviors follow the repetitive routine lessons, and their emphasis is on providing activities which can encourage drill and practice. Reward and punishment as the reinforcement is a key aspect of behaviorism, so it propagates reward and punishment, positive reinforcement and negative reinforcement. It stimulates or follows the stimulating activities which can engage or which can lead to a formation of certain behavior. Focuses on reinforcement and desired behavior. So unless the desired behavior is achieved, the practice or drill continues. Constant feedback is provided to the students. In the generativist approach, the classroom application of this particular theory focuses on providing a set of rules. Now that set of rules are finite number of rules, but they lead to the generating of infinite number of well-formed structures. So the idea is to provide the explicit rules through explicit teaching. They can present simple construction first, and then from there they can move on to developing a more complex form of structure based on that set of finite number of rules. Cognitivist approach follows the classroom application, which is based on activities to develop knowledge and skills from simple to complex. So again, we see the mental processes are involved from which they can move on to the development of their skills or knowledge from simple to complex stage and demonstrate learning outcomes in assignments. Assignments where the intellectual activities are provided, enough room is given for problem solving scenario, and that scenario also in the real life context for learning, and also assess changes in cognition. What type of changes that are introduced or changes that are brought about through these processes in cognition. Constructivist application follows teaching that involves students in collaborative groups such as cooperative learning, reciprocal teaching, and long-term projects. Children should have opportunities to engage in activities that closely resembles those they will encounter in the real world. So basically, they should be able to construct the knowledge focusing on something that they will encounter in the real world. So the real world or authentic context is of key importance in this particular classroom application. Group learning to internalize cognitive acts or activities. Monitor model follows teaching techniques based on the concept of comprehensible input. So any knowledge which is given should be precise, should be clear, should be easy. should not be complex and should be something which should not create any anxiety or tensions. Only then it is considered as comprehensible input. Socioculture followed the reciprocal teaching, which is the assuming of teaching-learning role or vice versa in reading sessions. Teachers and students collaborate, they sit down, through collaboration, they get engaged in a process of learning and participate. And here they follow summarizing, questioning, clarifying, and predicting as a normal procedure of practicing. Scaffolding and apprenticeship is something in which teacher or more advanced peer help or provide assistance to the learners. Evolution process of learning relies on successful application of its theories in real life situation. So basically, learning to be meaningful relies on theories which have a very positive contribution in the real life situation, which can provide assistance for learners to be able to express themselves effectively in a real life situation. No straightforward solution to learning, because learning is takes something that takes place in a diverse settings and context. Therefore, there is no straightforward solution that has been provided by SLA research. Narrowed domains in any theory or in any particular theory can restrict the understanding of teachers as well as learner, because it's very vast. The domain of learners is huge, and any aspect which is very specific will not be able to cover the huge domain that learner finds himself or herself in. Relationship between teaching and learning determines the relevancy of a particular theory. So the relationship a teacher has with the learning process or the learners have with teachers, they determine the relevancy of any theory or its application in a given classroom. Now we see the proposals for classroom teaching and research associated with it. So methods based on behaviorist theory actually propagates accuracy and form and not allowing errors. Methods based on interactionist theory provides learners the opportunity for conversation as well as where they receive meaningful input from teachers and students, which will in turn lead to acquisition of grammar and words of second language. Methods based on comprehensible input theory, most closely associated with Christian, where the emphasis is not on the interaction, but providing the input which is comprehensible through listening or reading. Methods based on teaching what the learner is ready to learn, most closely associated with Manfred Peenemann theory, which is the process ability theory, and method that recognize role of instruction but also assume that not everything has to be taught. So this is communicative approach. So we see that all these theories, they specify or they emphasize their particular specific aspect which should be incorporated in the classroom, or they form the classroom application. To conclude, teaching and learning draw on the specific framework propagated or proposed by these theories: behaviorism, generativism, cognitivism, constructivism, monitor model, and social culture theories. Every framework, despite its merits or demerits or constraints, provide teachers and learners with opportunities to experiment different methods and to take into account the diverse learning styles of their classrooms.